I'm Corinna Kolb from the University Hospital of Essen in Germany, and I'm a PhD student in the third year. My poster is in general about liquid biopsies, and specifically we did not only analyze CTCs, circulating tumor cells, but also extracellular vesicles, EVs, and cell-free DNA. And the spectacular thing about this project is that we analyze all of these materials from a minimized blood volume. So I was figuring out how to establish a workflow to just use two EDTA tubes to analyze all of these four analytes. So the CTC isolation was already established. We used the AdNATIST EMT2. This is a positive immunomagnetic selection targeting not only EpCAM but also EGFR and HER2. The mRNA isolation from these CTCs was established. And then in cooperation with QIAGEN, with the research department, we established multi-marker qPCR to analyze the overexpression signals in the CTCs, and then we used the cell-free DNA kit from QIAGEN with the magnetic beads, the QIAM MinElute CCF DNA kit. And for the vesicles, there was also a kit already available from QIAGEN. It was the ExoRNEZ kit. And this was quite interesting because you can directly lyse the EVs on the column and then effectively isolate mRNA from it. Challenging was the isolation of the genomic DNA from CTCs. This was the workflow we established right now. We wanted to use the remaining mRNA depleted CTC lysates to isolate the genomic DNA. And right now I'm proud to say that we managed to establish this workflow as well. So the overall goal was, after having all of these four analytes, having a comprehensive picture at the transcriptomic level but also at the genomic level, we can, with a variety of all of these materials and results, we can then identify actionable targets to stratify the patients accordingly. The next step will be sequencing the genomic DNA in CTCs. We have already patient samples in the library prep, and I'm really excited to get the sequencing results now.
QIAGEN.
Sample to insight.